As I mentioned, rational functions can also have a feature called a whole, and this particular example will contain that sixth feature, a whole. So let's start out the same way, factoring the numerator and the denominator as much as possible. So this numerator contains a common, greatest common factor of 2, so we get 2 times x squared minus 4. And the denominator you can factor by a method that I usually refer to as guessing and checking. So you see a quadratic polynomial. The first of the two factors, the first term, would have to be x, because x times x yields x squared. I would say peek ahead to the third term, which is positive 2, and think of two numbers, in this case 2 and 1, which multiply to create positive 2. Then, finally, look at the middle term, negative 3x, and make your mind up about the signs, plus or minus, which should occur in each of these two factors. When you finish your guessing, make sure you check it over. Okay, so in this case, x times x yields x squared. That's good. And x times negative 1 and negative 2 times x, they yield negative x and negative 2x, which total negative 3x. And finally, negative 2 times negative 1 equals positive 2. Okay, so this is correct factoring so far. Now the numerator has x squared minus 4, which is called a difference between perfect squares. It will factor as x minus 2 times x plus 2. Now, what we notice when we finish all of this is that one of the factors in the numerator is in common with one of the factors from the denominator. So that will cancel. Let's not scratch it out entirely, because it's going to come into play as we analyze these features. So, feature number 1, the y-intercept, as mentioned previously. You take x and you make it equal to 0. Probably in this first version of the equation will be easiest. And if we do that, this term becomes 0. We end up with numerator negative 8. And the first and the second term in the denominator are each 0. And we end up with 2. Finally, negative 4. So our y-intercept will occur at negative 4. The next feature to look at is the horizontal asymptote. Now, in this particular problem, there will once again be a horizontal asymptote, and we determine that by taking a ratio of the highest order terms in the original function. And so for the numerator, the highest order term is 2x squared. The denominator, the highest order term is x squared. They each are of the same degree, so that when we simplify, we end up with y equals 2. That is going to be the horizontal asymptote. So I'll put that over in the sketch right there. Y equals 2. I'm going to switch back to a blue color and throw in what I forgot to add previously. The y-intercept is occurring at negative 4. All right. So let's move on into feature number 3. Feature number 3 being x-intercept. And the x-intercept in this function, we set y equal to 0, which means we would get an equation 0 equals 2 times x plus 2 over x minus 1. And the only way this will work out is if x has the value negative 2. And we got that from looking at the numerator, the factor x plus 2, the only value of x that would potentially make that whole thing equal to 0 is x equal to negative 2. Let's actually go ahead and put that x-intercept in. X equals negative 2. And then let's continue on into a fourth feature, vertical asymptote. Now, as we saw previously, vertical asymptote will result from any value of x which makes this denominator 0. And the value of x that will make that equal to 0 is x equal negative equal 1. And as I said previously, really what we're saying is that x will not be allowed to equal 1. Let's go ahead and throw that vertical asymptote in. All right, fifth feature, an extra point. So fifth, an extra point. And I'm thinking that an extra point at perhaps x equaling 3 will be a good idea. And so let's take 3, sub it into the original equation. Y equals 2 times 3 squared minus 8 over 3 squared minus 3 times 3 plus 2. Which is 18 minus 8 over 9 minus 9 plus 2, 10 over 2 or 5. So that means that the extra point we're looking to put into the graph occurs at 3 for x and 5 for y. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, put that extra point in. Now the sixth feature, which didn't occur in the first example, which is referred to often as a hole, that is associated with the two factors in the numerator and denominator which cancel. We previously saw that x minus 2 and x minus 2 were factors that occurred in both the numerator and denominator. When you find such a combination, that means there will be, it's called a discontinuity technically, a hole occurring at an x value of 2 and at an unknown y value. We find the y value by going back 2, and I'm putting it in the light blue box right now, back to the expression that remains after the cancellation has occurred. So we take x equaling 2 and sub it in right here, and we end up with 2 times parentheses 2 plus 2 end parentheses over 2 minus 1. So that's 2 times 4 over 1. That result is 8. So there is a hole that we'd go to the graph, go to 2 comma 8, and literally draw a hole on the graph. Now, putting this all together, starting on the left-hand side, near the horizontal asymptote, and beginning to draw a curve which will dip downward, hit that green-colored x-intercept, curve down further, hit the blue y-intercept, and then curve and head infinitely downward along the vertical asymptote. Now, to the right-hand side of the pink vertical asymptote, we can see that there's the light blue hole and the black extra point. These indicate that the rest of the graph starts very high up, travels downward, don't fill the hole in because x is not allowed to equal 2. Curve further to pass through 3, 5, and eventually flatten out and head toward that horizontal asymptote of y equal 2.